Hi and welcome to the session. I'm Shashi and I'm going to help you with the following question. Question says, there are two types of fertilizers, F1 and F2. F1 consists of 10% of nitrogen and 6% phosphoric acid, and F2 consists of 5% nitrogen and 10% phosphoric acid. After testing the soil conditions, a farmer finds that she needs at least 14 kg of nitrogen and 14 kg of phosphoric acid for her crop. If F1 costs Rs. 6 per kg and F2 costs Rs. 5 per kg, determine how much of each type of fertilizer should be used so that nutrient requirements are met at a minimum cost. What is the minimum cost? Let us now start with the solution. First of all, let us assume that let the quantities of fertilizers F1 and F2 used be x kg and y kg. So we can write, let quantities of fertilizers F1 and F2 used be x kg and y kg. Now clearly we can see F1 consists of 10% of nitrogen and F2 consists of 5% of nitrogen. And we also know that farmer needs at least 14 kg of nitrogen. Now according to the given question, 10 upon 100x plus 5 upon 100y is greater than equal to 14. We know quantity of nitrogen in x kg of F1 is equal to 10% of x, that is 10 upon 100x, and quantity of nitrogen in y kg of F2 is equal to 5% of y, that is 5 upon 100y. We know minimum requirement of nitrogen is equal to 14 kg. So, sum of these two quantities must be greater than or equal to 14. Now, multiplying both the sides of this equation by 100, we get 10x plus 5y is greater than or equal to 1400. Now, dividing both the sides of this equation by 5, we get 2x plus y is greater than or equal to 280. This is our constraint 1. Now, we are given F1 consists of 6% phosphoric acid and F2 consists of 10% phosphoric acid, and minimum requirement of phosphoric acid is 14 kg. Now we get, according to the question, 6 upon 100x plus 10 upon 100y is greater than or equal to 14. We know quantity of phosphoric acid in x kg of F1 is equal to 6% of x, that is 6 upon 100x, and quantity of phosphoric acid in y kg of F2 is equal to 10% of y, that is 10 upon 100y. Now, minimum requirement of phosphoric acid is equal to 14 kg. So, sum of these two quantities must be greater than or equal to 14. Now multiplying both the sides of this equation by 100, we get 6x plus 10y is greater than or equal to 1400. Now dividing both the sides of this equation by 2, we get 3x plus 5y is greater than or equal to 700. Now this is our constraint 2. Now we know quantities of F1 and F2 required will be greater than or equal to 0. So we get x is greater than or equal to 0 and y is greater than or equal to 0. This is our constraint 3 and this is our constraint 4. Here we know that x is the quantity of F1 and y is the quantity of F2. Now we are given that F1 costs rupees 6 per kg and F2 costs rupees 5 per kg. And we have to minimize the cost. Now we get objective function Z is equal to 6x plus 5y. Cost of 1 kg of F1 is equal to rupees 6. So, cost of x kg of F1 is equal to 6x. We know cost of 1 kg of F2 is equal to rupees 5. So, cost of y kg of F2 is equal to 5 multiplied by y. That is 5y. Now, total cost is equal to 6x plus 5y. And it is equal to objective function Z. Now, the required linear programming problem becomes minimize Z is equal to 6x plus 5y subject to constraints 2x plus y is greater than equal to 280, 3x plus 5y is greater than equal to 700, x is greater than equal to 0 and y is greater than equal to 0. Now we will solve this linear programming problem graphically. Now clearly we can see points 0, 280 and 140, 0 lie on the line 2x plus y is equal to 280. Now we will plot these two points on the graph and then we will draw this line by joining these two points. Now clearly we can see this point represents 0, 280 and this point represents 140, 0. Joining these two points, we get the line 2x plus y is equal to 280. Now, this line divides the plane into two half planes. We will consider the plane that satisfies the inequality 2x plus y is greater than 280. That is, the plane that does not contain the origin 0, 0. Now we will draw a line 3x plus 5y is equal to 700 corresponding to this inequality. Now clearly we can see points 0, 140 and 700 upon 3, 0 lie on the line 3x plus 5y is equal to 700. Now we will plot these two points on the same graph and then we will join these two points to obtain this line. Now clearly we can see this point represents 0, 140. This point represents 700 upon 3, 0. Now joining these two points we get the line 3x plus 5y is equal to 700. Now this line divides the plane into two half planes. Now we will consider the plane that satisfies the inequality 3x plus 5y is greater than 700. That is the plane that does not contain the origin 0, 0. Now next two constraints are x is greater than equal to 0 and y is greater than equal to 0. This implies that the graph lies in the first quadrant only. Now this shaded region in the graph is the feasible region that satisfies all the given constraints. Clearly we can see feasible region is unbounded. Also note that these two lines, that is 2x plus y is equal to 280 and 3x plus 5y is equal to 700, intersect each other at point 100, 80. So coordinates of this point are 100,80. Now we know if the minimum value of the unbounded feasible region exists, it occurs at corner points of the feasible region. Now we know corner point of a feasible region is a point in the region which is the intersection of two boundary lines. So here, for this unbounded feasible region, corner points are 0,280, 100,80 and 700/3,0. Now we can write the shaded portion of the graph shows the feasible region satisfying all the given constraints. The feasible region is unbounded . Now corner points of the feasible region are 0,280, 100,80 and 700/3,0. Now we know according to the corner point method, minimum value of objective function z will occur at any of these points. So we will calculate the value of z at all these points. Now we know objective function z is equal to 6x plus 5y. Now first of all, we will find the value of z at corner point 0,280. Now substituting 0 for x and 280 for y in this expression, we get 6 multiplied by 0 plus 5 multiplied by 280 is equal to z. Now this is further equal to 1400. So we can write z is equal to 1400 at point 0,280. Similarly, we can find value of z at this corner point, that is 100,80. Substituting 100 for x and 80 for y in this expression, we get 6 multiplied by 100 plus 5 multiplied by 80, which is further equal to 1000. So we get z is equal to 1000 at point 100,80. Similarly, value of z at point 700/3,0 is equal to 1400. Now clearly we can see minimum value of z is equal to 1000 and it occurs at corner point 100,80. Now we can write thus minimum value of z is equal to 1000 at corner point 100,80, that is x is equal to 100 and y is equal to 80. Now 1000 is the minimum value of the objective function z if open half plane z less than 1000 does not have any point common with the feasible region. Now we will check if the region represented by z less than 1000 has any common point to the feasible region. Now we know z is less than 1000 implies 6x plus 5y is less than 1000. Now we will draw a line 6x plus 5y is equal to 1000 corresponding to this inequality on the graph. Now clearly we can see points 0,200 and 100,80 lie on the line 6x plus 5y is equal to 1000. Now this is the point 0, 200 and this is the point 100, 80. Joining these two points, we get the line 6x plus 5y is equal to 1000. Now this yellow shaded portion in the graph excluding this line represents 6x plus 5y is less than 1000. Or we can say z is less than 1000. Clearly we can see this region has no point common with the feasible region. So we get z is not less than 1000 in the feasible region except at 100, 80. Now we can write the yellow shaded portion in the graph excluding line 6x plus 5y is equal to 1000 represents 6x plus 5y is less than 1000, or we can say it represents z is less than 1000. Now this region has no point common with the feasible region. Thus, minimum value of z is equal to 1000, which occurs at corner point 100, 80, or we can say it occurs at x is equal to 100 and y is equal to 80. Now we know z represents the cost, so the minimum cost is equal to rupees 1000. X represents the quantity of fertilizer F1, so quantity of fertilizer F1 is equal to 100 kg. Y represents the quantity of fertilizer F2. So quantity of fertilizer F2 is equal to 80 kg. Now this is our required answer. This completes the session. Hope you understood the solution. Take care and have a nice day.